did Bizarre perform at the 10th annual gathering of the Juggalos or not?
I know King Gordy did. I'm not too sure if Bizarre did or not. I did a lot of drugs. I didn't really watch too much shit.
I believe he did, the day before me. He could have hung out and hollered at me about this. You see what I'm saying? If it was a problem. So I said, Bizarre, why you didn't holler at me at the gathering of the Juggalos? Like, they got up with me right there. I'm not hard to see. That provoked Bizarre. But I never said a fucking thing about Rasputia over there. I never said nothing about him. I never said nothing about King Albert, Fat Gordy, whatever the fuck his name is. I never said nothing about that cat. Like, he just jumped into some shit. And, you know, like, the whole thing, like, I'm really me for a reason. Lawrence, I'm not wanting to sit up here and pick up my opinion. Me, what's got me where I'm at in this business, I'm the numbers man. I know how many units Bizarre sold on this last record. I know how many units I sold on my last record. I know what machine has been used in the past to promote Bizarre. And I know what machine has been used in the past to promote Haystack. All I'm saying is that these cats just clowns. They not businessmen. Like, and I don't mean clowns, like, clowns. I mean, clowns, like, fucking these dudes is like, they don't get it. Like, and then Gordy got the nerve to tell me, I ain't Juggalo family. Bitch, you ain't Juggalo family.
Wow.
Gordy should have shut the fuck up, because if you put his sound scan on his last project and Bizarre's last project together, the bitches ain't still combined what I sold on my last joint. So.
Well, you already said this is going to be your last interview on the subject, so I'm gonna have them on the show. They're gonna say what they're gonna say. What do you gotta say to them? Let's put an end to all this back and forth shit.
Mind your business, and you either ride with us, or you be an eyewitness, or you over there with them bitches. And this is what it is, man. Like, it's only three ways to play it. I mean, I'm not with none of that neutrality. I'm not with no fuck boys talking to Bizarre and talking to and I'm not including you in that, boy. I know you in the media, and that's what you do.
Yeah, I know.
But you present multiple sides of the story. But what I'm saying is, other cats in the streets running and that's why I say it can't be squashed. Because I'm not going to feel comfortable, you see what I'm saying? Until I hear it from the horse's mouth. It's like, not the hog's mouth, not the fucking boar's mouth, not the fucking sow's mouth, Gordy and Bizarre. Who gives a fuck what they say? Fuck both them dudes, like they're nobodies. Well, I'm keeping them bitches alive. I'm literally beating breath back into their punk-ass bodies every time I talk about them. Matter of fact, after today, I'm still talking about them. I'm going to keep talking about their boss. I'm a man. I'm at the red light alone. You catch me, you don't gotta involve my people in this. And I'm that serious about it, Mom.
Harsh words here on the Suicide Hotline. You got the exclusive right the fuck here. And we're about to talk to King motherfucking Gordy, the king of horrorcore. And see what the fuck he got to say about this Haystack Eminem King Gordy Bizarre beef. I'm gonna keep it cracking right here on this show after this.
Yeah, what's up? It's Haystack Mac Neal, the original WB with my man Mars. And it's the motherfucking Suicide Hotline.